Here's a question for you. How can you succeed in your career while also staying true to your beliefs? Megan Alexander, national correspondent for Inside Edition and the author of a brand new book, Faith in the Spotlight, is here to tell us how, and she's got a connection to Ainsley.
But good morning.
Before we talk about the book, Meg, we got to tell our story. We're going to take a trip down memory lane because Megan and I used to work together for Ken's 5, which is a CBS affiliate in San Antonio, Texas.
Yes, okay.
And then we both got national jobs, so we were so excited. God is so good. We had a Bible study here in New York in my apartment for several years.
Well, and to be honest, when you got the job with Fox News, I thought, oh, I'll never see her again. You know, and then a year later, I got the offer with Inside Edition, reunited with you in New York City, and we rekindled the friendship. So you never know what's going to happen in life.
I know. I'm so proud of you. And now you've written a book talking about your faith and career. How do you balance it all? Because I know that can be tough, especially in the big city, and you're in the entertainment industry.
Well, there's no one-size-fits-all for this. Every day is different. Yeah. But the inspiration for this book, guys, came from an email I received from a pastor in Seattle. He said, Megan, I have a church full of young, ambitious women with big career goals and dreams, but they're worried they're going to need to compromise their faith to get ahead. I have few people to point them towards, but I know of you. Will you come speak to my church? And I said, I'd love to speak to your church, but I'll take it one step further. I'm going to write this book.
Oh, fantastic.
Max Licato, was it Max Licato's church?
Bothell Methodist Church in Seattle. And so the book's very practical. I mean, I try to talk about real-life situations, things that I've encountered. We tackle finding a mentor, climbing the ladder, negotiating a contract, dealing with body image, lots of real-life scenarios.
You know, and you have a different career than most of the people who are going to read this, but in particular, climbing the ladder is challenging.
Yeah.
For a variety of reasons.
Absolutely. Well, listen, I talk about the entertainment industry and media, but I think this can apply to anything. Hustling, working hard, there's nothing like it.
Hard work.
I've taken more red-eye flights than I can count. Yeah. We know that you have to do this, do that in this industry. So really, it's persistence and tenacity, but getting there. I really want to encourage believers to take a seat at the table, to be excellent at your job, and be a voice in the room when decisions are made.
Yeah, That's great. Hard work is definitely your mantra. You have done it the right way. Hard work and done it the right way. My dad always says there are two things that you can control, your reputation and your character. Tell the folks at home the story about when you were supposed to wear a dress you thought was a little too revealing.
Sure. Well, I try to just give practical examples. For example, Inside Edition often covers the Academy Awards, the Golden Globes, all the big award shows. And then the next day, we teach our viewers how you can dress like the stars at a fraction of the price. And so a certain reality star had walked the red carpet in a very revealing dress. And I was asked to model the dress the next day. I said, hey, good for her, but I don't want to wear that dress. Showing way too much skin. I don't think my father will love that. But instead of just saying no, guys, in the book, I try to encourage people to work the problem.
Yeah.
Say no, but then offer a plan B.
Right.
Here's another option. Here's another dress that Heidi
Klum wore. I've got a better idea.
I got a better idea. Let's figure this out because we're under deadline. We need to deliver for our bosses and for our shows. And I work with great editors, photographers, writers. We're all in this together. You can't just say no.
You can handle it just like you handled it. You can laugh about it. Oh, my gosh. She looks so great. I don't feel comfortable wearing that. Can we have a plan B? And you ended up with a dress that another celebrity wore, so
you still
looked fabulous.
That's right. You can work the problem. You can figure it out. And listen, some things will be absolutes. You got to determine for yourself what will be black and white for you and what you can compromise on.
What do you think the number one challenge is for young women, in regardless of the industry?
You know, I think it is figuring out who you are. It's difficult when you're young, Ainsley, when you and I are starting out, to know what you're going to be up against. But I try to encourage people, know who you are, write a mission statement, try to figure out, again, what those apps...
Really? How do you do that?
Well, you pen to paper, and you say, okay, what's important to
me? This is what I'm about.
Who am I living for? What's important to me in life? And again, try to determine what are those black and white issues for you, and then what you think you can
Some people use their mission statement as just a scripture. When I interviewed Mike Pence, his family has a mission statement. The "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to give you hope and a future." That's his
Jeremiah 29:11.
Yeah, that's his family's mission. So some people use that. It's great.
Yeah.
You know,
awesome,
at the beginning, Ainsley mentioned that you two had worked together. I think we found a picture.
Oh, there we are. This is our very first billboard in San Antonio.
That was our only billboard, right?
That was our only billboard.
Yeah, that was really cool.
Eyewitness News.
That was really cool because, okay, so so that was our team, morning and noon show. We all did the morning show, and then you went on to do another show, an entertainment show, and then I stayed to do the noon show.
Steve, I got to ask you, do you sing on commercial breaks? Ainsley and I used to sing, oftentimes Christmas music.
We did. We worked with a great crew, and they were all, we had so much fun, didn't we?
Good crew.
Yeah.
We're up early in the morning. You got to have fun, right?
It makes you a little wacky, doesn't it?
Just a little. little bit. Check out Megan's brand new book. It is called Faith in the Spotlight. Yes. Megan Alexander.
And tonight I'll be doing a live signing, 8 p.m. Eastern. Go to livesigning.com/Megan.
Okay.
You can buy a book, ask me a question, and
Fantastic.
We'll talk online.
All right. Good.